Hi guys, welcome again to another session of DMG tutorials. Today we are going to look at the trial balance, and I have already talked about the balancing of accounts, and you can check the description box and the link to that tutorial will be there, so that if you haven't watched, you check how to balance off the account, then you come and watch the trial balance as we take the balances from that account balances to prepare the trial balance. And let me quickly just give the explanation of the brief explanation about the trial balance. The trial balance is prepared to check the arithmetic accuracy of your posting of transactions from the journals to the ledger account. And after balancing of the accounts, you need to prepare or extract a trial balance to check the postings that you did, if everything was correct and accurate. So we say that the trial balance checks the arithmetic accuracy of your postings or your transactions recorded in the account and balancing of the accounts. Then also, as we say that the trial balance check the arithmetic accuracy, doesn't mean that error cannot be committed in the transaction or in the balancing of the accounts. There are six errors that can be committed, but it will not affect the trial balance. So, and on the other hand also, they say the trial balance in accounting, anything that ends with balance must balance at the end of preparing it. So the trial balance, we say that we prepare the trial balance to check the arithmetic accuracy, and it has in three divisions. We have the particulars, which will contain the names of the accounts. We have the debit side and the credit side. So all the accounts, and if you check from that tutorial, I made mention of the accounts and their corresponding balances, of which we got to know that all assets and expenses has gotten a normal debit balance, and the revenues and liabilities has also, or any other incomes has also gotten a normal credit balance. So as you know this, you know how to prepare the trial balance. And also, we take the balance brought down from the at the end of the accounting period, or the period in which you are asked to prepare the trial balance, to record or to extract the trial balance. So if the account has a debit balance at the end of the accounting period, or at the end of the period that you are asked to prepare, you take the balance from the balance brought down from there. If it is a debit balance, you put it in the debit side of the trial balance. If it is a credit balance, you put it at the credit side of the trial balance. And at the end, you have to total the two sides, and it must agree. So the trial balance must agree at the end of preparing it, or it must balance at the end of preparing it. So we have the list of balances from that tutorial that we did, the balancing of accounts. If you can check the description box and see the link to that, and check and watch after that, you see how we got these balances. So we have this list of balances from that one. We have capital account with 20,000, bank account 18,000, purchases 6,300, sales 12,400, drawings 1,500, and so on. Right, so these are the balances that we got from that at the end of the accounting period, or at the end of the time that we were asked to close off or balance off the accounts. So we take these balances or these balances to prepare the trial balance. And please take note that for this, we have all under one column, but each of them has its own account, or its own account balance that it should be posted to. We have debit side and credit side. Which of them has debit balance? Which of them has gotten a credit balance? Let's check from the trial balance. Right, so we start by taking the capital accounts. We know the capital account, which is a liability to the organization, has gotten a normal credit balance. So we have capital. So please take note of the currency that you are dealing with. Please, you put down the currency, or up here, the currency that you are dealing with, so that you don't forget. So that if anybody watching or looking at it will know which currency that you are dealing with. So the capital account had a balance of 20,000. So we put it on the credit side, that is 20,000, right. So the capital account with a credit balance with 20,000. Then we look at the bank account. The bank account with 18,000, which is a current asset with debit balance, we put it at the debit side. So we have bank with 18,000. Right, so you pick the balances, the account with their respective amount, and arrange it in such a way that which of them has a credit, which of them has a debit balances, to arrange it like that. And after that, you have to balance off or total the two sides. And the interesting part is it must give you the same totals. That is the work of the trial balance. So let's continue. We have purchases with 6,300. We have purchases $6,300 with a debit balance, right? Then we look at the sales with the credits, which is the opposite to the purchases. We have sales, and the amount here is with the purchases. The sales is $12,400, so we have $12,400 as sales amount. Then we look at the next one, which is drawings. So drawings also has a debit balance, of which we treat it in the statements of financial position or bank balance sheet at the end of the period or at the end of preparing the final account. So drawings also, we have our drawings with a debit balance with 1,500. 1,500. Then we look at the next one, which is the next balance or the next account, is purchases retains. Purchases retains also becomes a revenue to you, but we treat it in the trading account. When you purchase and you have to return to your supplier, it becomes, it goes to reduce your purchases amount, right? So you deduct from your purchases amount in trading account. So we have purchases retains, right? So that is 300. So purchases retains, we have it to be 300. So this purchases retains, sometimes in the trial balance, if you are asked to prepare the final account, the trading and profit and loss account, if you don't see whereby you'll be given the trial balance, to pick the balances from there to prepare the trading and profit and loss account. If you don't see purchases retains, you might see retains outwards, right? Retains outwards. So either retains outwards or purchases retains, it means the same, right? Then we look at the next one, which is XYZ Limited. And XYZ Limited here is XYZ Limited is another organization who supplied ABC Limited goods on credit. So XYZ here, you see, becomes a creditor to the organization. So if a creditor, right, let me indicate that so that you know where to put it. So we have a creditor. So this 2,500, we have XYZ, who is a creditor, XYZ Limited, who is a creditor. We have 2,500 at the credit side. 2,500 on the credit side. Right, so this is our purchases retains, our creditors or XYZ 2,500. Then we look at rent. Rent also, which is an expense to be treated in the P&L or the profit and loss account. All expenses and assets have gotten a normal debit balance. So we put it at the debit side of the trial balance, which is 1,000. Right, so when we finish that, we look at the next one, which is sales retains. And the sales retains also with 400. Sales retains also, which we treat it in the trading and profit and loss account, which has a debit balance. This sales retains, when you sell goods to your customers and they retain some of them to you to reduce your sales amount, so you deduct it in the trading account as sales retains. And that one also, sometimes you may see sales returns or returns inwards. So in the trial balance, if you see returns inwards or sales returns, it means the same. Take note of that. Right, so we have sales returns. And that is 400 CDs, debit side. Right. Then finally, we have BB Enterprise. So this BB Enterprise is also a customer that goods were sold to on credit. So we have also data, which is a personal account. We have data to be 8,000. And all data also has gotten a normal debit balance. So we have BB Enterprise. BB Enterprise, who is a debtor to the organization with the amount of 8,000. So when you are done with taking all the balances from the list, you go there to total the two sides or to balance off the trial balance. So in balancing of the trial balance, you total the two sides. And it should be on the same line. Right. So you total the two sides. We total the debit side and the credit side. And the main thing that we are doing this thing is to make the two sides agree or to balance. But if it doesn't balance, meaning there is some mistake or discrepancies somewhere. So we look at that, and the total we have 18,000. Can we place? We have 18,000 plus 6,300. 6,300 plus 1,500 plus 1,000 plus 400 plus 8,000. And that gives us, the debit side is giving us 35,200. Then we look at the credit side as well. We have 20,000 plus 12,400 plus 300 plus 2,500, and that is also giving us same amount, 35,200. So you could see that the balance, or at the end of preparing the trial balance, it has agreed. The two side is giving us same amount, which is 35,200 each. That is the main thing, or the reason why we prepare the trial balance. And it is very important to understand which balance each of the accounts has gotten. Without understanding the concept or the balances of the various accounts, it is very difficult to draft the trial balance or to extract the trial balance. So please take note. If you don't understand anything, please put it in the comment section, and do subscribe if you haven't. And please, if our lesson or tutorial is very important to you, just push up the like button, and I'll be very grateful to see your comment. Your comment is very important to me, because I need to know what you understand, what you didn't get it clear, so that the next tutorial we can just polish wherever that we need to throw the more light on. In our next tutorial, we are going to look at some errors that will not affect the agreement of the trial balance. The trial balance has agreed all right, meaning everything is okay, but there are some errors that you may incur or that will arise in the posting of the transactions to the ledger account, which will not affect the trial balance. These are errors that we are going to see. The trial balance has agreed all right. So we are going to see those errors, and there are six of them. Six errors that do not affect the agreement of the trial balance. The error may arise all right, but still you may have your trial balance agreed or balanced. So that is what we are going to look at in our next tutorial. Please stay safe and be following us. Please, when you subscribe, ring the bell button, so that anytime that we upload a video, you will be noticed to also watch and follow us to complete the accounting journey together. Until we meet again, stay blessed and stay safe.